Cuz.
Yeah.
Nah, I was talking to you. You hear me now? Yeah, my broadcast up, man. It's up. Cause the shit that I just did, I tried to send it to you. And some shit, I don't know, but what it's doing now is download. So you'll be able to see that whole motherfucking game to where it ended at.
Hello, everyone. And you're tuned in to Mag 18.
That nigga went to YouTube. He on YouTube right now.
We got a good one on tap today. Mm-hmm. And there's going to be two quarterbacks
ready that to motherfucker get it say, hold up. He put the broadcast down every time he do that play. And he scored off that shit. I hope I get the ball back. Oh, yeah, I get the ball back halftime. I'm about to do everything I got to do in the first quarter.
Here was the scene. The Falcons coming out from their tunnel to the roar of all the folks here in Atlanta. We're ready for football as these Falcons get set to match up with the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Let's go. They don't want to say that no more.
The 20 and down at the 22-yard line.
Be quiet as well, folks. Mute his mic. He ain't in the chat. Yeah, cause what he said, I don't respect what he said. That nigga would have lost. That's why he would have got the offside. Nigga, 9 times 10, ain't nobody getting a motherfucker offside. Now, you probably would have, I give it to him, he probably would have scored within that minute. And that motherfucker offside kick, though, bro.
A first carry for the tailback, fuck Devontae man. Freeman. And he'll take this that's one up close to the 25-yard line. A gain of 3, 2nd down. Man.
Partner, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different than normal.
Yeah, I don't know why he did that, though. That fucked me up.
That's not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself.
That shit fucked me all the way up right now. I'm like, damn. Why would Cripple do that? We have viewers.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. On 2nd down, Freeman. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup there,
on,
so it'll
stop
leave him with
third
a third and about four more
ball
for
back.
First.
Come on, Crip. Let me sign the receivers you got out that bitch. They ain't trying to show me. Must ain't playing this shit, man. Come on, Crip. He ain't even playing. Nigga don't even want to play no more, cuz. That nigga don't even want to play no more, man.
And the defense searches
but yeah,
for
why the fuck you put him down, though? Like,
after the run on
you know
down.
He was a suspicious sheet muster. How that YouTube shit work?
Here's Ryan to throw.
Fuck down, man. You see that shit, cuz? They ain't playing his ass. This my game, man. This should be 3 straight, y'all, cuz. Yeah, 3 straight, cuz. I'm trying to beat this ass.
Now is this one sent away. Fielded at the 20.
Ooh, can you see that shit? Oh my God, God. If I would have got past him, that would have been a fucking touchdown.
The offense will take over with a new
this
set of downs.
This cripple is lucky. Better than my fucking medium man and shit. He playing attention to him.
He'll be down at the 30.
You see what he's doing.
Go
you see what he's focused on.
It'll be second down.
So you know what you do. You know what you do. You know what you do to dead people.
You're really hoping those defensive
linemen. Oh, shit. I'm bury his ass right here, man.
Look, if they stayed out late the night before the game, they're not moving as fast.
He's focused on the run too
much.
He's focused.
He focused.
Watch me work, huh? I told you in game he beat me with a fluke. That nigga ain't want to choke me, he must be sneaking. He hit me that fucking Lilo. That nigga ain't talking down, man.
Portals on the give to Fournette.
Oh, he tripped me. I never saw that.
Pick up and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Yeah, man.
Let's talk a little football 101 here because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on
once
first down.
I'm just wondering my defense
as we know between 2nd and 4 and 2nd and 8 and 9.
Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter.
We could we just call him? We called him in that. We caught him in the motherfucking ass. Yeah.
Now running again with Fournette.
We caught him in the ass because he had his YouTube. We caught him in that
shit. It's a loss of two.
We caught him in that
down.
Shit.
That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats. But really, should he have to absorb that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him. Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step. It's a gain of five, and now the question, will the offense stay out there on fourth and one?
But a good play is made on defense. Oftentimes, leverage is the key to everything. Defensive line not getting time. All the other guys making sure they're in the right spot.
It, man.
On that play, they were able to stop him short of a first down.
The Jags come up empty on fourth down.
That was a good play,
huh? Defense stands tall.
My man, he almost stayed in the seat, though, but shit. My other man probably went out there, but...
The play fake to Freeman.
Ryan.
It's Ryan.
I made that nigga do a fucking similar. Come here, Ryan.
And seeing no options, he just tosses
that nigga Ryan scared of shit.
Now that'll bring up second down.
Thank God, that nigga Ryan. I don't know what the fuck to do. Throw the ball away.
That's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it, or no one
man,
gets it.
What?
Give him a lot of credit.
I got him in his head now, because that's all you gotta
no
do.
One got it.
That's why he ain't on that mic. He ain't trying that shit.
So the D-line's going to spread out. Ryan.
Get him.
And he
can't
escape.
He's pulling
the miles on you, Ryan goes down. Yannick
Ngakoue
in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon.
Hey, Chase.
Third and long. It's Ryan.
That's a lucky shit. Bro, he be getting that third down shit like it ain't nothing, bro. It be the most luckiest shit ever for him, dog. Like, it's something that he's doing. I don't know what it is, dog.
Now Ryan on first down.
Come on, motherfucker. Watch. Get
the fuck. It's
like, if you give him time back there, dog, it's gonna be a nigga. Oh, he's just gonna throw that bitch. He be wide the fuck open. Like right now, he's short because I'm not gonna keep tapping X in this circle.
Now Ryan on second down.
Look.
And he takes a shot. Release, says this will be incomplete.
That's why I'm fucking up. Like my niggas be right there to grab him, but I be hitting the circle and you know the little X moves and all that shit. That should be fucking me up from the other side.
Lucky just to get rid of the ball with the arm going forward. Could have been a fumble.
Yep. Let's go. Come on, give me this ball back.
Throwing on third and long.
Uh-oh.
Ryan,
yeah.
This is
cool. Told the coach he took the shit off on third down.
Big 32-yard play on third.
Third down, dog. The nigga says that, cuz.
Third. Marching the ball downfield.
Third down.
When you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays. That's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types
he
of plays
scoring,
that can
though.
Knock
he
a defense off
here.
Balance, that
he
will drive
get
the
three.
Team towards a victory.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down
he
completion.
Need three.
See, in that play, and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL.
Oh, there you go. He's got a touchdown.
Touchdown, Atlanta. Devontae Freeman. A 6-yard touchdown run. And the Falcons have taken the early lead. Well, Devontae Freeman scored the first points of Super Bowl 51, and he's got the first points here as he's in for six.
And I don't want to be snarky here. It's going to come off that way a little bit, but that didn't work out so well for them in Super Bowl 51 against New England when he scored the first touchdown in that game. But I like what they've started with here. Now, here's the thing about Freeman. I love his game. Can run it inside, can get to the perimeter, can catch the football, pass protection.
Yeah, that
nigga did that
last game.
Though,
for
the game.
That's all he was on
the
playing
Jags
the second game.
The Jags offense now gets set and heads
I mean,
back onto
game.
The field.
He was going to really realize, I mean, think he would have won that. Like, no. Fuck no.
Start out on the ground. It's Leonard Fournette. And a short gain there, so get it up only to about the 24.
I mean, he ain't stopping my mama.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
And that's why you see a lot of teams that like to play 4-3 defense, especially against teams that run the ball really well, because you count on your defensive front, the tackles, and the ends, game to eat up the blocking in the offensive line and keep that guy in the middle clean so he can roam through the football and make a tackle. In this case, he introduced himself and said, "Hello, my name is Mike.
I just got to win this game, that's all. I'm not even going to look for the blowout."
On second down, here's Bortles. He finds Hearns left side. And he's able to get up here to the 26. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down.
Looking for the win.
From the gun on third down, Bortles flushed out right. Gonna let one fly for Robert. He rifles one.
Yeah,
it's intercepted.
Here's my control. Fuck all this
stuff.
I'm not throw that shit low.
41-yard line.
This is, I can get the ball back. I'm still in the
way. For two reasons. Quarterback gets outside the pocket and panics a little bit. And receiver doesn't make sure he's absolutely in an open spot. There's a guy lurking, took the ball from us.
Yeah, he ain't trying to talk to me. Shit. Should make him a door.
Gotta know that you're open. I bet if I hit.
Look at that Joe Killer. I bet if I hit the switch on my motherfucking face. Look at that like, man, shit. Look, shit like that. That nigga be knowing he's catching that shit. He even got that.
It falls down incomplete. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver. And it's third down.
Come on, y'all. Watch. It's third down. Watch him get this shit. Watch him get it. See niggas watch this shit.
And he motions the wide receiver.
Hey, you know what it is, cuz? You think that's him that's winning there to look at my play?
To throw on third down. Ryan. He's got some.
I'm on a call chase. There ain't nobody landing this on top end of though, so I know that's what it is.
It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs.
There it is, son. I'm going to turn it on off.
They toss to Freeman. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
But forget about finding the lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
Oh, oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Oh, thrown back across his body.
Oh, that nigga went out of bounds.
Around the 37.
Hey, why the fuck do receivers slow as shit, bro?
To make a play. Sometimes whether he's open or not.
Another receiver like I have San Francisco,
yeah.
That one nigga fast as shit. He smoked the shit out of his whole team.
Bortles gonna run the draw with Fournette, and he's gonna get this one down near the 45. All right,
that was
a 3 yards.
I'm good. I'm good.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
So I get it up there.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. They'll run with Fournette, and running room scares him. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Officially, no gain on the play, and on. They're left with a third and eight.
I'm out of passes, bro. So I'll fuck with some defense up.
The play fake to Ivory. Now Bortles. And incomplete here on third down.
Well, sometimes those cliches really come true, don't they? When they talk about it takes all 11 to play good defense. We've seen that in this ball game. I think
I'm calling Chase. He ain't answering the motherfucking phone and shit. I know that you can't even tell who on your shit, huh?
And this one, they'll force another incompletion.
Throwing now is Bortles. And Robinson with a big catch.
Nah, that's another person in here, but I can't see the name of who.
And it's good enough for a Jacksonville first. And that's what you got your tough little slot receiver for, isn't it? Right there.
Yeah, he's going. You see how he's moving the field.
He knows that's where he has to make his living.
That nigga,
and that's where he has to make plays to help his team.
I got
team.
This nigga on his cell phone trying to win, though.
Do anything more or less.
If you flat out stop this play right here, son, he know what I'm doing. He don't know what I'm picking, but he can get that shit together.
They'll run it now.
Yeah, he
don't
know what the fuck I'm doing.
See,
I beat his ass that bad, he won't hop in the shot. He won't hop like that.
Hey,
that nigga got the shot, guy.
And that's going to lead to a third down. From the gun, it's Bortles. Lewis has it.
Oh, stay on your feet, bad boy.
I'm about to drink this whole time when I was like, hey, you know what I'm saying? 3 points.
Yeah, get the ball back.
We're back to Atlanta. Right timeout. And now inside the red zone, the offense
will operate. Fuck it. Kick the three. Get the ball back. Let the time run out. Fuck it.
They'll try and run for it with Fournette.
Oh, shit. That's cool.
And he takes it in. Touchdown.
You know when you get the ball and you move the angle left to right, I just, the angle I had that bitch in, the angle he ran in that motherfucker. Oh yeah. Cribble give me this motherfucker ball back, that's a wrap.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away.
Shit. Yeah, he's probably looking at my defense plays, bro. Y'all don't even give a fuck. He gotta stop it. Oh, look. He know what the fuck I'm doing. He going three wide receivers off the break to see what it is. I'm about to throw him off, though, cuz. Yeah, that's crazy, son. Hell yeah, he looking at my shit. He trying to figure out, hey, I'm trying to tell you.
Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw.
Yeah, he's on it. He's on it. He's on that funny shit.
They're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
Come on,
here's Ryan. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's see. Yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. That throw good for four. It's second down. From midfield now, here's Ryan.
Interception. Interception and a touchdown, cuz. Oh shit, interception.
He's running, baby.
He's sleeping.
He's holding.
What?
You look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at your defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They got them frustrated right now.
Oh, they said he got him frustrated right now. Fuck yeah, he did.
On the run, it's Fournette. And he'll take this inside the 30 to about the 20. Maybe the 28 yard line.
I totally can't fuck with him, man.
Give him three on first down.
He got his days, man. See, I don't practice or none of that shit. I do all that shit, man.
They'll toss it to Fournette. And he will get the yardage here to the 31 yard line.
Maybe that nigga run off fast and shit.
Defensively by the Falcons. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. The Jaguars on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and ten. To throw is Bortles. And he's going to be taken down. Back around the 35-yard line.
Yeah,
and the Falcons going to use another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
Ooh, nice fucking three.
And this one is right down the middle.
Come down fast.
And they take the lead here now at 10-7.
Pick them again.
So they had great field position, but a three-play drive actually goes backwards. And then they kick the field goal.
I think the key sequence in there, the key phrase you just gave us, a three-play drive, had the momentum, great field position.
He's on three wide receivers.
Atlanta now coming out on the field.
What do you think goes on here in this situation?
If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory, just a little time. Do you try something?
I'm going on my play, but I don't want him to keep looking at shit. I know that's what
you're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete.
Very
nice pickup of 33 yards.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
Ain't nothing, motherfucker.
Now, before this second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. Here's Ryan. Forced out to his left. Now he'll let it go deep left side. And it's intercepted at the goal
line.
Come on, guy. Good positioning, and it's picked off.
Ah, shit.
He has got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
Hey, I shot him when that big back.
James trying to get it all back in one play, and it
didn't feel like a pitcher working his way into a 3-0 count, right? You're behind. What do your coaches always tell you? Get it back one pitch at a
It's out, and the Falcons grab it, and they have the football, and will take over at the 24-yard line.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me.
He kicked 3 points off the brick. He kicked 3 points off the brick.
And how much they practice.
Oh, shit, everything. Oh, miss it. My nigga fucking fumbled. Nah, he made it. My nigga fucking fumbled, bro. That's the name, man.
And that 3-point tally now means we are even here toward the end of the second quarter.
Yeah, we fucked up. I'm gonna make something happen.
Put some points on the board, feel better about yourselves as a team, and you're right back to even.
And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And from this spot in the field, the clock runs out. I think we're just going to see a knee, and that's
it. I got a better chance
running. In this situation, that's the proper
play.
We do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one.
And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best. Yeah. As that brings us to the end of his first half of play. Welcome back. Halftime.
I should have never ran that bitch up the hole. I should have put it in the air.
Number three alongside
cool,
Charles
though.
Davis.
I'm good on defense. I just got scored.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably
much.
Should have stayed where he was as he'll only get back
to
the 16-yard line. Out come the Jaguars now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum
okay.
to begin the half.
Okay.
What do they have dialed up
okay.
that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
After the penalty, it's Fournette. And they'll bring it down at the
27-yard line.
3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
Man, I want one of them tall slaves, but it ain't in my fucking playbook. Like, this tall slave, we not one of these type of jokes. I want one of them strong ass tall.
The pitch to Fournette, and that time he's smothered as he's wrestled down right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, second down. He's fumbled already once, Charles. I'm not going to say that that was in his mind there, but I'm sure that during some of these plays, he is mindful of it.
And once you fumble the ball, you know what your team tells you and your coaching staff? Take care of it, rest of the game. And it does get in your mind a little bit. Sometimes that slows down your effort in trying to get free from tackles.
And the defenders know it, too. They sniff that out.
Everybody wants to swarm the football. You know the rule is, first guy hold up the runner, everyone else try and get there and strip the ball free.
Working from the gun, it's Bortles. Middle of the field,
My nigga.
Yeah, they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. The 21 yards there as they convert on third.
I fucked up that crib. I should not have won this shit.
They go back to the ground now with Fournette. Room inside the
floor.
That is brought down.
Look at that motherfucker run,
15 more there, and they're on a roll.
That
it's another first down.
For me.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this
that's
game
a call
is
like
patient,
right? I'm playing for Peter.
He's had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big
they need to make the next jump down there, though.
That's a good start for him.
Your blockers, man, be aggressive.
Tough sledding right there. Chase. When he's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Stopped short of the 25, but that second effort got him a couple extra. Call it an 8-yard gain. Much better shape now on third and just a yard.
Yeah, man.
The Jaguars on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. They'll try and run for it with Fournette. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive. So here we go, first and 10 now. Out of the pistol, it's Fournette. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
They'll try the right side here with Fournette. Fournette, a first down, still going. And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. A great effort there. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Jaguars have moved out in front. Here's Lambeau out to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. Oh, nice spin.
Oh, that brought back bad memories.
So we get set to start this third quarter. Here's the Falcons offense now. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that. They weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
Gets this to the 24 for a gain of 4.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutralized. And he's going to be out of bounds at the 39. A phrase we said a lot last year, Ryan DeJones for a Falcon first down. This is Freeman on first and 10.
Whoa.
And this Rock has been a afternoon as they stop him behind the line. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play. On second down, Ryan. He's going to wind up and air it out. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked up by the linebacker, Miles Jack. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line.
Man, let him count. No, you won't. Oh, that's a nice job defensively to get a piece of
the
ball.
He's going to pop it into the air. And then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and pull in the interception.
They begin with a run by Fournette. And some room to work. That good for 22 and a first down.
I know that play went to the left side, and that's what it was designed to do, an outside handoff there. But how about the whole offensive line being involved? Seal the left side where the play was going, where they call play side. But how about on the back side? Just taking care of business to make sure no one can get there and disrupt it.
Is the biggest key to left tackle?
Without a doubt. Control that edge. Get out there. You want that left tackle. If you bring your tight end over there, either way, control the edge of the line of scrimmage, you got a chance to rumble.
The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Fournette, a first down carry. And he gets stopped up at the 31 after a gain of maybe a yard. Well, with the fumble he had earlier, we know how key keeping the football is here. That fumble earlier, probably at the forefront of his mind. Just hold on to this thing.
It's also at the forefront of the mind of the guys who are trying to get the ball from him. And since they've seen him drop it on the ground before, they're doing everything possible to have him do it again. They need that turnover.
No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd-and-9 situation.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now. Just stop them, get to the ball. That means it might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. And this one is right down Broadway. And they double him up here. That makes our score 20-10. So his second field goal of the game, and that could turn out to be the big one.
Yeah, you have to make them score twice to beat you, and that's not impossible. But here in the fourth quarter, puts their backs clearly against the wall.
And the decision to come out is going to cost him five as he's taken down right at the 20. Atlanta now coming out on the field. Shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time, make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
Second and 10. It's Ryan again. And they are going to take over right there at the 22-yard line.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games, and now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
Here we go now. 390.
A toss running left. Fournette fighting him off. 11 yards there for Jacksonville and a first down as well.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down. On this day, the ground has been his, but at least on that individual play, we just saw the defense finally with a win.
Yeah, they finally got one, and that's a win for them, but all game long, he's seen the holes, and they've been huge for him. Kind of like a baseball hitter in the zone. The ball seems bigger, and he's just whacking it. These guys, they've got it going today.
They'll get a couple yards back, but not more than that. They'll be left with 12 yards to go on third down. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down. And the play clock's running down. They give it to Ivory. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. It's a 7-yard run, but it does bring up fourth down. And Lambeau will put this one through. And that will stretch the lead up to 13. So they settle for just the three there, but clearly anything helps when you're trying to salt one away here in the fourth.
Without a doubt, I think a touchdown would have been the final nail. But three does give them some breathing room and lets them build up a little cushion.
Now after the made field goal, back out Lambeau to kick this one off. Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over.
Yeah,
and
man, this shit over, cuz. I don't know what to tell you, but good game, though. Yeah, good game. All right.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He's got his man on the crossing route. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. On first and 10, it's Ryan. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. And this is taken in at the 5. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones, 64 yards. And the Falcons draw a bit closer. And the lead will shrink to 6. Here's Boscher to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Toss to the right. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. Calling a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to try to play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Now Leonard Fournette. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. The Jaguars on third down. They've converted a third of their opportunities, 3 for 9. This will be third and 6. To throw is Bortles. A dump off for Ivory. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. The Jags picking up the first down there, a gain of 12. Huge first down, got to hurry.
Yeah, now they have to get up there, get set, and then spike it.
They'll run it now, out of the gun.
This shit is over. I just called him. Nah, I called him. The Falcons going to use another timeout.
That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter.
I told you, Chase still in the party, bro. He ain't saying it, so that's probably him. My cripple took his head, man.
To Fournette, and he'll be tackled right on the midfield logo. That's going to be a 6-yard gain. It leaves him with third down and just a yard to go. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside.
Tell this little nigga about fucking with me. Tell this little nigga, my ass is going. This shit is over.
Bortles with a knee to the ground, and that should do it.
It's over. Hey, we ain't be thirsty, man. It's over. He saying this shit too, cause I called the call. I was like, man, lost again. I should have run it all the way up on his ass. Beat his ass all the way to 6 o'clock.
You never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
Pride the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this.
He is
only
ass,
people
who
believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
That nigga about to lead a check, huh? Oh, shit. Look at that shit. Look at that shit. He be getting that bullshit off. He keep throwing deep passes, slim. That nigga be smoking the shit out of him. Nigga, cuz, this the game you need to watch. This show on YouTube. Watch this whole game. You're like, damn, he was working. Nigga, I was his ass. I told him he could have fucked with me a long time ago. Who you talking to, cuz? Yeah. Look at that shit, man.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis.
Let's look at some of these highlights. Nigga, it was a play I did. I don't know which one it was, dog. I think this is an interception he took. Look, this play right here, watching this shit. Yeah, this nigga smoked this shit out my man, dog. He got a guaranteed play he can do, so. Oh, yeah.
That's why he was wide open. Though. That was a linebacker cover on Julio Jones.
That nigga smoked the shit out of him. Look, that nigga threw that motherfucking interception.
Ain't gonna keep up with Julio.
Look, that's what did it for him right there, this interception, right? That's the game he controlled in the game. Moot. Pick. Look, that nigga, like, he ain't coming here say he want to play again or none of that shit, because he's sick. I will play him. Nigga, don't be listening to us.
As we go on.
Nigga, you never left the chat, but your mic was in the gay party. It wasn't in the chat. I mean, what I'm just saying, Cripple, I beat your ass again. Nah, fuck that. That's three straight running back. I want my fourth win. Let's go. I want my fourth ass woman, man. Let's go. Let's go. Oh, it's coming. Man, believe it. There you go. Nigga. Yeah, you won the first game, and I just beat you three straight games. Yeah. I didn't win the first game. Remember, I had San Francisco. That was a game I was supposed to win. I ain't win that game. I've been sending it. Hey, cuz. Yeah. Give me fourth L or just let him breathe?
Nah, I ain't gonna breathe.
What would you do? Beat his ass again or what? I got stay on his neck. This should be off this week. Let me stay on his neck. Yeah, this one right here, this just shows that he can't fuck with me, man. Right? So he just had his day that day, but that, before that, I was on his ass. Yeah, he showed his ass today. He took the broadcast down, all that shit. Break in the bed. Like what? I'm about to cover it. This is the last one. I'm gonna lay right there. Lay right there across from the couch. Get my sweat, honey. Hey. Ain't no new music out. Hey, I not whoop your ass tonight, man. You gonna learn. You know what? What you trying to play for? Play for, you gotta delete that motherfucking 49-0 jump if I beat you this one. Oh, you know motherfucking game. You ass shit.
Tuned into the NFL on EA Sports.
Nigga, that wasn't no stamp bet. We ain't make that shit official. Man, you tripping.
It's
Ryan's
Falcons going up against
Jaguars.
Larry, we welcome our
viewers. And you just bringing that shit up all these days and months and shit.
The Sunshine State is EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to Everbank Field here in Jacksonville.
Nah, you the
crowd excited to see their Jaguars as both teams emerge from their tunnels a moment ago.
Oh, can I get a run back?
Ready for football as the Jags get set to match up with Matt Ryan and the Atlanta Falcons.
I should have played with San Francisco, man.
And some changes here as the D-line separates them. On first and 10, here's Bortles. He finds an opening pass to
the right back to the
center. Mercedes Lewis with a grab. And even 20 yards and a first down on the game's very first play.
I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this as this game progresses, because when you can have that type of a game in the middle of the defense, it hurts them in so many ways, because most teams like to be strong down the middle.
Man, you can stay that's on there, you. Okay, I thought that was on me. I thought my niggas go over first.
That's where he, their big tight end.
Hey, but you know what, though? Woodman that was, they don't call pass in the first place, bitch, yo. Woodman that was, they was calling that shit so much.
They'll run it now, out of the gun.
That was like 2001 or something like that. On up from there.
On first and five, and it leaves them with a more stable.
I mean, they call it on here, but it's really short.
Now Bortles throwing on second down, looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40.
I'm trying to blow
Reds
out of the water, though, cuz I just need that one game today. I'm trying to get some new set of downs. Yeah. I mean, I don't want them to score. I want one of them games. I don't want him to score. See, that 10, what was that 10 or 36? That was an ass with him.
Officially, no gain on the play.
That wasn't an ass with him.
Well, a well-executed blitz, no doubt. Great job,
man,
by
that was like, that was last month, B.
That was last month. Yeah, he needed to be in a different play.
Yeah, it's easy now, B. That was last month.
All the gaps were filled, except for the one the offense really wanted to run through. And that was filled by a big man wanting to make a tackle.
Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Brooks Reed, able to use that strength.
That was last month,
B.
I just gave you three. I just gave you three damn ears right now. Gave you three this month. Yeah.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41.
Oh, no.
Just a gain of two there, and it's going to bring up a fourth down.
I mean, I'm over the jump. That's a long swing. That's like a, that's a 58, man.
So coming on now is the field goal unit. They're going to try for three, and he'll need all the leg he's got here.
Yeah,
now before they run this fourth down play, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
I'm going to miss off. Good name.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. Here we go now. Left, 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 left. They'll go for it. It's Bortles. But he's got it to Burns. And he gets us all the way.
Now, what you say? Come again? I think you should have took your ass to sleep, though, man. Don't let me beat your ass all night at 6 o'clock.
And that'll be good for Jacksonville first down.
Beat your ass at 6 o'clock, man. Yeah, you bullshit.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Okay. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll in fact tackle him behind the line.
They
lost two there, and it's third down. And our statistician, Ben Ramsar,
man,
has held
you
up three fingers.
I'm making it look good.
He now has three tackles for a loss rolling in the first quarter.
Well, Ben's got a detail. Technically, he always gives us the right stats. I'd love to be on the offensive
side. Yeah, nigga. That's what the motherfucker supposed to do.
Someone please block him. Come up with something. Make sure you block him.
Hey, that nigga's
crazy. Losing 4 yards that time, and now it's fourth down.
I mean, that's it's like your stadium.
Down
visitors come to watch their team. You know what I'm saying?
Certainly wouldn't rule it out with these guys.
That thing is crazy.
And field goal caps an 11-point
drive.
That's a lot
of offense
to only get 3 points, but they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
Yeah.
Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30.
That would be that ass. He was rooting for me, nigga. Nigga, you wouldn't be one of these up out. You just got up for a second. You ain't never controlled the game.
Intercepted.
Hey, you get your ass beat on my broadcast. You know my jump's still up. So I got a lot of videos to watch.
Don't
worry about it, my man. You know, it's my day. That's all.
Fournette running right. And he's got room.
That's the way you want to be saying my nation, because
the Jags picking up the first down there, a gain of 12.
Has a lot of beef thundering downfield off of the toss play.
I'm just good, it takes though, me back to when I was a kid honestly, watching. I don't practice this shit. So I just play this shit. Like, I ain't got no go-to plays or nothing. Just play this shit.
They keep it with Fournette on first down. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they know how to finish plays, too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
On second down, here's Fournette. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
That's two really good stops in a row. Back-to-back tackles for losses. I mean, let's face it, they are locked in to what they're doing offensively. And now,
I had a whole man over
there. They're going to have to do something else because the run game, at least on this drive, isn't working. So he can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Right, you know a coach said that, right? Yeah. Not an actual player, not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
So after the pick, they can't capitalize for six, but they do get three.
And I know in this situation, most of us wanted to focus on the offense. You know what side of the ball I played on. Let's give that defense a lot of credit. Taking it over in a sudden change situation and shutting them down.
Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take
over. Hey, little Diggy.
And last time, interceptions. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play call.
Faggy boys having an answer. They on their feet and space. Take care. You ain't here covering the whole time. That nigga over here talking about he took the broadcast down, right? Because my cousin kept cheering for me. Are you mad?
And those are the highlight real runs you dream
that's
of.
That's some petty shit.
When he gets a seam and just gets through it, how about the explosiveness, the burst to get there to begin with, and then once he's in full gallop, good luck trying to track him down.
And those plays so demoralizing.
Don't
defense.
He pose to them, bro?
He
pose
so much work trying to keep people in front of you. When they're past you and behind you, that's a tough one to swallow.
Fielded about a yard deep. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Here comes the Jaguars offense as they get
set.
Hey,
that's what
kind of searching for that magic elixir. You know, they're moving the football.
Hey. But I mean, what you expect? You've been losing like shit, dude.
I love that term you just used, elixir, right?
School.
Old school.
Straight.
I love that. Because you don't want to put too much
pressure
on your defense
one
as well.
That's all,
right? If you're kicking field goals, that's great. But your defense has to keep going out there and holding the other team. You're not giving them any cushion to work with. And that gets tougher and tougher as the game goes along.
Yeah.
Put the ball in the end zone and get sixes. That's the ambrosia that they're looking for.
Ambrosia and trying to
come on, you talking about Twitch?
Now they'll run it on the toss.
But them guys and kids don't count him. That's in the pussy league.
Right there. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a third and nine situation. The Jaguars on third down. 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is third and nine. Shotgun now for Bortles. And the Falcons get there.
Shit.
The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Adrian Claiborne coming in to drop him for a loss of 8. And it'll be fourth down. So on fourth down, the Jags send out Brad Nortman to punt.
How the fuck are you scoring on that run, sir?
This will be fielded at the 17. Very good return that time. 18 yards. And that will come the offense as they take over. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here?
Can you see if I got a screw tomorrow?
Hopefully there's some determination that sets in. Because I think they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guy.
I shouldn't even send Lally at for real. Because I ain't going
to want to. You shouldn't have nobody else give him their school.
Nah, but it's screwed him up.
Nah, no, it's not.
It is screwed him up.
But your kid's school. My kid's out of school.
BC Trailer School's out of school.
My kid's school, though.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays
to target him. Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target. And he'll take this one down to about the 40. A gain of 3, second down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles. Because we have to just eat up blocks, allow other people.
Interception, baby!
He's on broadcast, they heard your voice like that.
Nah, I took the mic off. I ain't no problem.
I'm about to say, boy, it'd be like, that shit gonna be on World Star.
That's it, dude. I'll be famous. What happened to the nigga with the golden voice? That nigga got on you and went back smoking coca. You know what I'm talking about? The nigga, the weather reporter dude with the golden voice, that nigga a beast, man.
Back to the running game, it's Freeman.
That nigga motherfucker went back to smoking.
Does that keep the drive rolling?
As a matter of fact, he was on the radio. I think it was the news or something. Yeah. Oh, I'm back.
That was a good one. Julio Jones, a 12-yard touchdown grab, and the Falcons will extend their lead.
And that lead is now 7, with a chance to go to 8 or more if they want to get crazy here, which we don't expect, but I just know the way the game's being played with the analytics, there's going to be a lot more of going for 2 in a lot of situations, isn't there?
Yeah, there's going to be, and I think their focus here, they don't want to give up anything going into the lockers on the other end, just a little foul at him.
Oh, no. Oh, he got it back. Good shit, my nigga. So save the game for me.
After all, but that could have been a disaster.
I didn't do this in college, but I did it in high school. When you return kicks and you lose it yourself, the panic that goes through you and the determination to get the ball back, I don't even know how to describe it. And I think we just saw an example of that.
That's right. That's right. Get that ball off the hand, baby.
Yeah, you go to the sidelines, you know you're going to get yelled at, but you can handle it because you got the ball back. I think he had that low down before he wanted to. He was right
up in his grill. I think he's a dentist there
without a license, don't you?
Right, then you see it. Oh,
just not enough time for the play to develop.
Who was he?
It wasn't fumble, really. That was him, and Bortles fumble. It's loose, and the Falcons grab it, and they will set up
Jacksonville
territory at the 13-yard line.
You ain't put Adam Robinson back in the game?
Yeah, he in the game. Well, you know when you
get stuck.
I mean, he's slow. He can't go on a flex.
You just expect that to get better with experience in the league.
Oh, and of course,
better support from his offensive line.
In this case, though,
that nigga, like, you know, you look at the receivers. That nigga smoking the shit on, like, they negative.
But instead, they'll keep it on second down.
That's because he's who he got.
He got the fucking
on second and 10. It's
you know what the fuck he play with?
His
cornerback's
quarterback's fast as shit. That's it. Cause your I think Young got like a 91 speed. So whatever the negative is, that's what he got more than him.
Yeah.
But that don't mean nothing. You got to look at their route running and their release too. Cause if you look at their route running and their release when they. Yeah, like when they make the cuts, if you look at where it say release, if that shit like 22, that means when he make that cut, he going to cut way faster than that nigga going to react. You remember when you used to try to run man, or that, I think it was cover 2, I used to do the outs. Nigga, I used to do them outs because I knew the motherfucking release always gonna be on time. But y'all play some type of difference. I don't know what coverage it is yet. But y'all niggas be playing, they be stopping the inside. But the niggas just stand in front of the rope. But where you gonna go? It's holes in every zone. You just gotta find the hole. And if you play man, sometimes that release shit get you burnt up. Because you'll have a linebacker checking the wide receiver.
As it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back out here. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive. As they score here, especially a touchdown, it's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team, and their drive and will to come back and win can be taken.
Score
right here. Still third quarter. Man, you just get that feel. Yeah, the team right there on the brink on there. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. A gain of 32 that time. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. On the counter, Devontae Freeman. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. And no more. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. So the D-line's going to spread out. Freeman again.
He's going to get that ball back.
This go around, he's hit behind the line and taken down. And he'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. Now on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
That's the game, nigga. Hey, let's do it.
Okay, basketball.
Yeah.
To throw is Ryan. And the Jags get to him as down he goes.
2K, that's why. We will play 2K.
Gets him down. It'll be a loss of five.
I don't even know the whole line, though.
Down.
I thought he was just a real live radio.
It's a real live radio head,
all right. On is the punt team now as this one sent away. This one angles out of bounds in a good spot in the coffin corner. And they're going to mark this out of the 5-yard line. Here comes the Jags offense now. Time for their first possession of half number two. They're able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter three.
They can really take charge, can't they? And this is probably how this
I
know it's out locker room, all right? And I think we would see them on the grease boards. Stop them defensively, get the ball back for the offense, and let's go downfield and score. Seems simple, right? The last part, we have to find out that's going to happen. But the first part worked to perfection. Did exactly what they wanted, and now their offense has to pay it off.
See if they can get the line at 50%.
Oh, damn, drop it. Hey, I didn't mean to throw it to that nigga, Joe. I'm glad he did that, yeah.
I
swear I didn't mean to throw that shit to him, man.
The Jaguars on third down.
I didn't mean to throw it to him, for real. I swear I hit the wrong button because I was shaky on the play.
From the gun, it's Portal. And he finds his running back. It's complete. And he'll get it up a little shy of the 15.
Look out there, 2 touchdowns in the third quarter.
5 yards on the pickup, and that's gonna bring
nigga, you was down shit, nigga, and you know how it was. You on that bullshit, I should have put it. I'm on a fucking 14. Yeah, I have to go for it.
Oh, but how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're gonna go for it. They do go for it. It's Bortles. He's got the hook up to Lee. Breaks through the contact. And he'll go out of bounds across the 35-yard line. 22 yards on the pickup there. And the Jags are going to have a first down.
So, when you see shit like, what the release mean?
It mean when they break from their routes. Like, if you run it in. And when he break in, that means when he take off, he's going to release from the
That was a dream chance for any defense.
cornerback. He's going to create space. That's why when they run like them in little, if you run in the end route, if there's no safety over top, as soon as he make that cut, he going to separate from the nigga. It's basically like the other nigga's reaction time. So if you put that bitch on the money, you still can make shit happen. It's all on your quarterback.
I never knew about that shit.
You gotta look at the route runner. The route runner. When you looking at the route runner showing how good the nigga route's gonna be. Like, if you got a nigga that can't run routes good, when he do little outs, you drink not gonna do shit. And the speed and the, yeah. But sometimes the speed don't matter. Sometimes you have a nigga, he had a 98 speed, but if he can't cover him, he can't cover him. The nigga gonna get, like, you can't nobody cover Antonio Brown 1-on-1. Nobody. Him one motherfucker, Julio. Niggas can't cover niggas 1-on-1 if they route running too good.
Thank you for holding back, nigga. Thank you.
They might want to do the same thing, but control the game offensively. Put together some first downs, put together a drive, and keep it away from them. That's good for 21 yards and a first down. Freeman again, first down carry. And some space here.
Oh, fucking Falcon
touchdown. Devontae Freeman. That's his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Falcons will extend their lead.
Don't worry behind you, that's all.
It's up to 15 now. Here's Bosher to kick it away. Field about a yard deep. And he'll take it out past the 25 to the 26-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time. It's still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit. Maybe pump up the pace. Maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
To throw his balls. Left side by Robinson. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 11 yards there for Jacksonville and a first down as well. Throwing on first down is Bortles. Completes it to Lee. And he is knocked down from the side. First down, Jacksonville. The passing game looking sharp on this drive for the Jags. Bortles now on first down. Eluding the pressure right.
Huge
yardage here. As they will switch ends as time has run out on this third quarter play.
Fucked up.
Bortles on the give to Fournette. Room to run inside the 40.
Hey, that was the best fucking run to play all game. And I did a lot of that nigga bounce on every fucking block and score.
51 yards. And the Jaguars get a score closer.
I didn't expect that shit.
It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how we're going to slow down this running game because of that particular play.
Man, they had no answer.
Feeling about a yard deep. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. So out come the Falcons now. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are you going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Thank you,
and not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Oh, come on. And we needed that. And we needed that. We fucking needed that, baby. We fucking needed that. You challenge this shit, baby. Come on, man. That was fair game, man.
This game, the game is really called 4-minute offense, and that's practice, being taking care of the football, taking time off the clock, not giving them a chance to come back. The bottom line is, what did I say in the beginning? Taking care of
the football. Oh, get the fuck out of here.
Do it, a costly turnover. Nice pick up there as he'll take it from the 10 to the 5-yard line.
Well, Brandon, we always know that we're just going one touchdown.
You're
without a
touchdown, motherfucker. You're a sad motherfucker. Touchdown,
Jacksonville.
Dead way.
A great play there. With now two fourth quarter touchdowns. And the Jaguars move back within a couple of the lead. So here we go now as the Jaguars will go for two. And he whips that one incomplete there. And the failure to convert and tie the game. Now the pressure shifts back to the defense.
But I think it was the right play.
Boy, defense. Count on it.
Tie the game there.
Count on your defense.
Down one. What's the sense? I like what they did.
Feeling about a yard deep. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line.
We
know
the
Falcons as their offense heads back onto the field. And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You've got to protect the football.
We know we go. We know we go.
Because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there to atone for it.
And try to atone for it here on this drive. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
That's your ass, but.
That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves
you can't afford no fucker.
I think this defense tired of seeing them on the football, and this D-line probably gets sick of the O-line as well.
And as I'm watching this, I'm thinking about conversations with Adam Gase, the head coach of the Miami Dolphins in the offseason. He told me that he asked his running backs each week for their favorite runs.
I'm not dabbing for that shit.
And right now, you're seeing a guy that's probably using his top runs to great advantage in this game.
He is in a zone. And Ryan on the handoff. It's Freeman. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 10 more there and another first down.
I've got zero rooting interest in this game, but this is a lot of fun to watch. When you watch a guy get with his offensive line and have that great relationship,
cool. Yeah,
I think
cool.
It has to be built during the week, during training camp, throughout the season, sitting and watching tape together, finding where their creases are, the gaps, knowing how guys are going to block. And right now, he's almost unstoppable.
And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Devontae Freeman. A 9-yard touchdown run. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. And it is good, and the lead will swell to 9.
9-point game, B.
Here's Bosher to kick it away.
Out this motherfucker and slam dunk.
This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. Bortles now on first down. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And get
let's
his
go.
Man complete.
Oh, you know I'm going to come down and slam dunk. Fuck you, man.
A big third down play there for the Jags. 44 yards.
Don't check everybody, Chip.
On first down, Bortles.
Come on.
His throw is going to be incomplete.
Hey, check everybody, Chris.
Intended receiver. And now it's second down.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want. Get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up like that well. That really goes incomplete.
This is four down. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35. in need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. Wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
And Lambeau will put this one through. And that'll move them back within six now. All right, so you needed two scores to get back in the game. The field goal then maybe not exactly what they wanted, but it's a necessary first step.
Still plenty of time remaining, but you can really use a stop defensively after the kickoff, preferably a three and out.
Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. And we have seen a lot on the scoreboard here in this quarter. So sometimes you talk to me about tendency breakers on offense. These defenses struggling. Are there tendency breakers on defense?
All defensive coordinators keep something in their pocket.
We know he's going to fumble for me, B.
What can we do to slow down the onslaught?
We know he's going to fumble.
But the biggest thing is make sure these guys encourage each other, pick themselves up, because right now it's been a really tough ball game trying to stop these offenses.
It really has, especially as of late. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. Now Freeman, he's been busy today. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Not in a position where they absolutely have to rush right now, but they definitely have to pick up the
tempo.
That's
what your mouth says, brother. That's what your fucking mouth say.
And maybe a measure of revenge there.
You better get something else out of them, because don't. You gotta punt that bitch. You did. You did.
Short game, last two plays. Who do you think's excited about that?
Absolutely. This defense are saying go right ahead with those.
Yeah. Yeah. Get his ass. Put that bitch. Put that bitch. Put that motherfucking bitch. Let's go. I want you starting to force a good time on that clock. You let that shit tick all the way down. Let's go.
And now the Jags defense deciding to call a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Here's Matt Bosher now. As he'll punt it away for the second time.
We score, we win the game. We score, we win the game.
Just got a 2.5 point command here so far in the first quarter.
And this will get inside the 20 and be touchdown just outside of the 15-yard line. Out comes the Jacksonville offense as they get set to take over here. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences.
What the fuck happened?
OMG, man.
What the fuck was that? Why my man go like that, B? You saw that shit?
When we have the opportunity, they've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Yeah, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. They'll look to throw. Middle of the field, it's Robinson. And he's brought down after a good game. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
They're clearly saving those timeouts, but they still have to work with some urgency to put themselves in the right position.
He's going
to
leave this for his running back. It's complete. Now the Jags will use the second timeout. As it'll come with 36 seconds,
dude. Anything
can
happen.
Half number two.
Anything can fucking happen. Anything. I'm just saying. You lucky he ain't scored right there. He had it.
Back to throw. Now a desperation throw deep down.
Touchdown, bum ass nigga. Fuck you, brother. Fuck your fucking brother. 28 seconds. Hey, God. I threw a fucking touchdown pass. My man threw that bitch like a dolphin. Let's get money, B. Let's get money, B. 28 seconds, B. 28 fucking seconds, B. That's not the way.
Here's Lambeau out to kick this one away.
That's fucking low.
Fielded about a yard deep.
Man, he'll wind up
getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he brings this one out to the 27. Atlanta now coming out on the field. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range?
Get him! Get him! Stop this fucking run! Stop this fucking run! Stop this fucking run!
Dance class, anyone? Did you see the steps between the quarterback and the running back?
You need a good counter.
You have to have it because you're setting up your blocking. There's a timing element as well.
Time to y'all
speed. Steps. Otherwise, that timing is thrown out the window.
Timing you ain't gonna get it. Had a big run.
You ain't gonna get it. 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 There you need 11 yards.
Hey, a lot of points have been scored in this game, but what a nice play by the defense. Stepping up on that one. Maybe they'll get things going in their direction after a play like that.
He's back to throw. Dancing to his left.
Pick, motherfucker. Game over, cripple. Stop playing that bitch on that 4 games straight. Hey, yo, I'm going to beat your ass to 6 o'clock in the morning now. This shit is over with, nigga. This shit is over.
That's the baby boy.
This shit is over.
Hey, girl, you got your ass beat by a fucking toddler.
Hey, girl. Hey, cuz, I beat his ass 4 games straight, dog. He thought he was gonna win this shit. I threw that touchdown pass. That bitch was beautiful. God damn, cripple, man. You put up 21 in the second quarter, I put up 23 to 4. Stop playing me, man. You some shit. Look at that shit.
Hey, yeah.
Only if you want to play the 6 o'clock, man.
Nah, I ain't fucking with you. I'm gonna enjoy my 4 wins and play it tomorrow. I'm gonna watch the movie. I'm gonna do anything with that. But nigga, you can stay up, go up on YouTube, try to stop some shit. You know what I'm saying? He stopped my run game, right? I just kept throwing that bitch. I got 278 yards. He had the run game tonight on this one. That nigga had 292. He wasn't really throwing that bitch. That nigga cripple fucked the game up, Chase. That nigga fucked the game up. He thought he was about to win that shit. Tell the truth, you think about to win that shit, Crip? My nigga came down that motherfucker. I gotta look at that instant replay, dude. Dog. This nigga, yeah. Smoked the shit out of him. Hey, Slim. You couldn't do nothing with that run, y'all. I mean, that passing play. Your man missed that tackle, Slim. If he would have got him, that would, he probably had a chance. He missed that tackle, and I dove in that end zone like a beast. God. Yeah, Crip, you gotta go practice some more. 4 games tonight, brother. My man, it ain't nice, though. You ate too much. Yeah, last month you did that. That shit ain't about nothing. Because before that, I was beating your ass just like this. Yeah. I got that, too. Oh, nah, there ain't no ketchup, Crip. That's awful ketchup. Yeah. If you ask me, that's like mustard. You tripping. But last month, I was whooping your ass, too. I was. This one you whoop. Yeah, it's old news. But we talking about this month. This April 1st. Actually, this April 2nd, nigga.
Yeah, I ran down to your ass. 4-1. Yeah. And we got 31 days to go. No, 30 days to go. Where? You beat 4 straight games. You beat 1 game today. What are you talking about? I'm lost. Man, Cripple, just face it, man. You lost 4 games today, man. It's all right. You're 2-4 today. Man, stop trying to make it win though you was on top. Nigga, you the first game you won. Yeah, the first game. And I won the rest straight. I won straight. I ain't won none that night. Yeah, that was that night. Cripple, I don't give a fuck how you making it for you to feel comfortable by taking the 4 L's. It's whatever. You just lost 4 games. And this game right here, you lost 3 games in a blowout. But this game right here hurt you the most. This game hurt you the most. Nah, because you had the game in your hands. You had the game in your hands. Hey, Chase. Yeah. Man, I ain't talking about no Rams, man. Hey, you lost, B. You live to play tomorrow, B. I told you, I'm gonna beat your ass all the way until they turn my internet off. No bullshit, I'm gonna be over here tomorrow and I'm gonna beat your ass. I'm not losing to you ever again. You know? Hey. No. I wasn't even supposed to lose that first game. Like, I can do it with San Francisco. I did it before. But I needed some more steam on your ass. Damn. And I put the extra steam. I need that line. You know? And that's what did it. Because the offense with San Francisco was decent. Like, yeah. Yeah. But this the touchdown play that you took the L on right here. That nigga did that motherfucker touchdown. Oh shit. Then when you do that fucking interception, I know you was upset like a motherfucker, man. Hey, that nigga threw a fucking interception. I mean, either way it was gonna be my ball, but that just made it clear right there. Like, hold up. Yeah, this shit is over. Oh, shit. I don't even know why you threw that bitch anyway. I mean, that dude was coming back with a ball, but my man got in front of that bitch and say, hold up. This shit is over, but. Hey, I'm so fucking smart. I kicked that field goal. I'm gonna kick a field goal regardless. Because I knew if I was to get the ball back, I just had to score and I'd be up by 1. And look what happened. I scored and was up by 1. And nigga, you had possession and blew it. Oh, shit. And nigga out here dealing the ball and shit, cuz I'm keeping my wins. Fuck that. Let's go. Interception. Damn, well. That was a good game, man. Chase, anytime you want to go back and watch that, man, you can go ahead and watch that. That shit on YouTube. That shit on YouTube, my nigga.